All right, Bob. We are actually already loaded up in the game. That was quick.
Uh-huh.
No time for non-loaders. Gotta load, get unloaded before. Gonna switch a couple assets over here really quick, and then we'll start talking about things. Actually, you can start talking right now. You've got all the words.
Okay. Well, I guess, are you actually in-game, or are you just loading up in-game, I guess?
That's where we are. We're in-game. That's
okay.
Where we happen to be.
Okay, so you are ready? We can do intros?
Yep.
All right, cool then. To the south side of the map, we have the red Terran player taking out Kelizer 3-1, guys. It is time.
Very good stuff, Bob. And in the top right corner, we have Major, who actually took out Scarlet 3-0, which is impressive in its own right.
I know. And they're good games. Really good.
Yeah, they were nice. Very good, very good indeed. Just gonna put on here that it's a best of seven, and we'll get this one underway. Actually, I'm gonna make this map slightly darker. Just slightly. You know, not too much darker.
We'll have to figure out a way to adjust the name tags. Like we'll have to create like an overlay or something like that, I think, at some point. You know, for players who have like, you know, non-English names on them or barcodes, just for the viewer pleasure. Otherwise, they're not seeing who's who.
Yeah, I mean, I think especially for our new setup, it'd be super easy.
Yeah, I mean, it's something we can definitely do.
Could very easily do that. In fact, it could even sync up to my bracket.
Yeah.
We just use the same name all over the place. Wouldn't even be hard.
Yeah.
Because, here, you know what I'm going to do? Actually, no, that won't work. Actually, I think it might. Hold on. No.
All right, I'll hold.
I was just going to draw it over, but it doesn't work like I wanted it to. It is. It's time versus Major. Everybody knows.
Yeah. Well, that's something we'll sort out in the future, and anyway. We'll make it happen as we're always looking to try to improve the little things.
A little bit of a standoff happening here. Not going to put any country behind it, but it's that type of standoff. Both sides defining their ramps against the other side.
Well, what country would it be if you did?
Didn't want to say it, Bob. Not saying it. But it's that type of standoff.
But it wouldn't be, even if it was the country.
But that's the type of thing.
But it isn't that type.
It's pretty close.
You'd need one more party, wouldn't you?
Oh, there's a third party. We're the third party, Bob.
Oh boy. Anyway. Element for ya. Alright, so we got a Cyclone already out here for... This is gonna be a bugger for me, actually, when I'm casting it to remember who's who. Write down barcode. I know this.
Well, you should know, yeah. Time's been to barcode the whole time.
But when you're calling things, it's just sometimes just... you know how it is. You say what you see. In other words, otherwise. All right. So no player pushing across the map quite as of yet, getting similar forces back at their safety and confines of their main base. Getting out some Widowmines now is Major behind all this too. Now Major, his play in his TVZ matchup is a drop heavy, drop oriented style. One could say the same thing as far as the TVD is concerned for time from what we've seen from him. But one's of the Doom drop variety, one's of the multitasking rip your face out from multiple angles variety. Now, as far as Major is concerned, he's shown proficiency in both mech and a bio. I think bio might be his more preferred style, and as far as in general is concerned, although we saw him pull up both against Scarlet in the previous series. Now, TBT is a significantly different matchup. Although that being said, preferences still apply, as I don't expect us to see a whole lot of mech coming out of Major, in other words, against Time. And now Time seems to be a bio-oriented player as well, and I expect the same. So, gonna be Marine Tank versus Marine Tank in all likelihood element in this series. Somebody mentioned that in chat as well. It seems to be highly likely between these two guys, which I'm not complaining. It's a fast-paced duel of styles, and duel of similar styles in that case. And then Ravens on the field too.
Yeah, just about gave its life.
Almost.
Unless you're Bobby, don't do that. If you are Bobby,
especially,
go ahead.
Especially if you're not Bobby. I don't know, Element.
Usually you do know. Not today, though. just tap something
on that regard.
The side there. Every time I go to type something, Bob stops talking completely. I believe Bob is now a robot designed to kill me.
Oh, you know, it took you this long to figure it out.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Act more human. Beep, boop, beep. Oh, boy. Okay.
Oh, man. Wow, we got these ravens. The tank. Doing pretty good.
And not a whole lot of... Oh, so that turret was kind of a waste.
Yeah.
Wow, looks down to, be the to case. 2 health is that raven.
Yeah, super low.
Sacrifice itself.
Managed to keep it alive so far. I like this little bit of aggression. What do you really equate this, you know, harassment as, Element? Like an oracle, perhaps? Or what? It's just, it's really interesting, because the utility of these auto turrets extends far beyond than that of what an oracle can do. I mean, you could lock down some mining, force the workers to be pulled, much like an oracle does. But the speed in which you could kill all air units, too, so the defending ravens or vikings themselves are under threat. I definitely like this. And now he will... Oh, it gets away just... Barely, Element, 15 health left on that Raven. Playing with fire here is major, as the third base is still about just over halfway done for time, as the third base is now flying over as an orbital command for Major. So I'm definitely enjoying the position of Major as he's pushing across the map with a follow-up attack. It looks like, nope, he's just going to siege up at his third, which is, I think, the smart play here.
Yep, Medivac up is coming out here as well, Bobby. For time, like you said. Oh, the push is happening. You were right.
Oh, it's not a push, it's just a little expeditionary force. He left his tanks back at home.
I thought Major was pushing out, yeah, you're right. Good call, good call.
Either way, this is a pretty scary drop, but there's a tank in defense. Another tank, in fact, just popped out. And enough Marines here to defend against this push, pushing back time yet again. With that sensor tower down as well, we'll definitely give him fair warning of potential drops. That seems to be the MO of time, as far as this matchup is concerned. Ooh, gonna meet the Cyclone, take it out, no problemo. Here is time, further eliminating the map presence of Major as he secures his third base as well. I'm liking this element.
Okay, fine. You can go ahead, Bob.
No, go ahead.
No, you got the mic now.
I was literally just gonna say what you. I was just gonna say what you were saying. I'm like, yeah, he saw what happened in the previous series. Got that sensor turret up. Like, you know, I'm not taking any more of these doom drops from you.
That might hit about as much as it possibly could have hit. And these medivacs, if they get a chance to heal it up, will. But that was a pretty good mine. Quite happy about it.
Did his job, Element. Looks like a big attack here coming from time. There's not a lot of forces available at this base for Major, though, Element. We'll clear up the rest of these tanks. This immediately lifts up the natural base. Does Major gonna retreat to the high ground of his main base?
There's a counterattack going on. There too. Bob with a double drop happening as well on time. So the pushback is that. I think he can break up this ramp if he wanted to, but perhaps he doesn't realize the situation he's in. Just a little bit of vision with that medivac, but loses it. And time is ready to greet him in the lower base as well. Tank at the third. If he does drop, he will lose some units to that tank. Check out the battle over here. Might be time.
Yeah, time is starting to run away with this as well. Considering he did lock down that third base, he's also locking down some of this production too, taking up some of the structures in the meantime. He did deflect that drop, as you showed before, from a Major. Major's still going to try to get something done, but just the forces are much too large back at home here for time to take out these back rocks, trying to find an opening, whatever he can, is Major. But I'm really impressed with the way this kid is playing, as time has Major on effective lockdown.
Yeah, I agree. It's
how he's gonna break up this base?
Maybe he's telling me that time was a really, really strong player, and I've seen it now, definitely.
Yeah, I believe, man. If you haven't believed before, you do now. And I like the initial staging of Major and his position. It was just a commitment yet again of the large portion of time's forces.
Both medevacs? I think both medevacs are gonna go down here, Bobby. One of them did. Oh, can he catch it? Oh, it's close. No, doesn't quite get it, but
no.
One flew right over the army there and did go down.
Alright, the Major is still not out of this yet, guys. He is on two bases, though, so the time is ticking heavily in favor. Never mind. Heavily in favor of time himself. And I didn't realize what I was saying. And then... And so it looks like one final push here from Major, gonna try to break this line. And it looks like time's not gonna have any of it, gonna make his way back home, picks up his tanks too, so the Marines don't catch them lagging behind. He will lose a couple forces perhaps, but a well-planned retreat from Time and gets up with a large portion of his army as he joins up in the middle of the map with the rest of his forces.
Major himself? Looks like
that's what I'm thinking. Like, it's on the cards, man. That's what you gotta do, bro.
I mean, you can't fight right against this huge amount of tanks. You just can't. Oh, God, he's going. No.
Oh, he's gonna do it. Oh, no, you don't have nearly enough!
I guess. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He doesn't realize the position he's in, I think. This is next to GG right here.
Yeah, I mean, Time did lose a lot there, too, but it's just, well, just too many numbers here, especially in the tank count for our Chinese player, and that's it.
Incredible.
Wow, indeed, Element. Incredible.
I thought that for a moment during that game, we were going to have an old-fashioned Canadian standoff. After you, Bobby. No, after you. No, I insist. You go on, sir. Oh, please. I didn't have any words to say worthwhile anyways.
That is a Canadian standoff. And we did have
I apologize profusely. Yeah. Oh boy.
No, it's my bad, really. Yeah. On myself.
Oh god.
I don't know, I'd like to actually hear their opinion on that. I find it highly entertaining, as it did say in the previous game, because it starts the action off right away. And it never stops, because then it goes into right from there into a push out, and then into drops, and then into multiple drops, and then somebody GG's. It's good stuff, Element.
Good stuff indeed. Bobby, in the top bottom left corner, it is Major. I don't even know why I said top. I don't even know. Take it away, Bob.
Well, you always do, Element. To the southeast side of the map, we have the red Terran player up one game. It is X-Team's Time. Element, ever have that moment when you're driving and then you make it to your destination and you don't remember the journey there? You know, those weird moments are like, wow. yeah. I mean, seriously, this happened. Well, I remember some people were talking about it on social media.
I have walks from the top floor to the basement where I'm just like, how did I get here? What am I doing? Why am I here?
Yeah, it's like, I don't remember my drive to this location, which is like, you know, I don't know, 15-minute drive, I remember back in the day. And I'm like, I don't remember in between. Like, how did I not die in between? Like, how did I
subscribe
and not perished?
Go for it. He's a baby. Reborn.
What?
Did you get it?
Oh! I didn't see that. Okay, didn't see it. Oh, well, Fractal Cactal resub for 9 months, guys! He says, 9 months. M-born. GSC Bobfield. Well, happy
Was it
birth.
M-born or newborn? What did he say?
It says A-M-born. M-born.
I think he says I am born. I don't know.
I think that's what he means. I am born. I'm gonna say that. I am born. Yeah. So Fractal Cactal, longtime supporter, of course, of the channel for that. Thank you for hitting up that resub, man. Really, really, really does mean a lot to us. Subs are super important to the channel, and it means a lot, man. Thanks so much for that. Long-time supporter, man. Always around. Like it. I like seeing the regulars and new people as well. We had, obviously, a new sub today as well. Means a lot. And we'll give a proper shout-out at the end of the broadcast as well to everybody who hit up that sub button or donates and stuff. Because it means a lot to us. All right, Element. Yep.
Just for Fractal Cactal, we're bringing a brand new functionality today. It's called player cameras.
Never been used before.
I don't think any online cups ever use before. I'm just going to go out there and say it. I don't even know if they have one picture-in-picture going. Now we're just doubling it up. Getting fancy now, yeah. Bob.
I know. Where does it end?
I don't know. I was thinking we should bring in seven or so, but, you know. There's only so many angles you can capture if I was showing the whole map. That'd be something.
That's true.
Bunch of pictures all lined up together. Anyways, a little bit of attack going on here. Let's jump into the main view. Just pokes up, as Bob would say. Just a poke. Just a poke. Tire armor's gone. Just poking.
Oh, the Captain's getting real low on health. Oh, it does manage to get away. Look, a little weird path there against the Cyclone. Oh, I say he's going to get away. Oh, but what are you doing?
You doomed him.
Poor man. Oh. Time.
The Bobby curse.
Does not love his Hellions. The Bob curse. It kind of is.
This map, they have to update the tile set. Just please, somebody, please.
You keep saying that. But it is true.
Me. It's like the lowest res.
Especially after res we're running, and the quality, it's like you notice it when you're running that.
Might as well go down to 240p at this rate. Anyways, drop coming in here. Four major.
Drop indeed. That's going to be met with some pretty heavy resistance, though, from Time as he's locking it down with the auto turret of that Raven. as well as a cyclone of his own.
The mine! Oh my god!
Oh, nice hit!
So lucky he didn't target the medevac fully, though. That could have been
dangerous. Still takes out that cyclone. Pretty rough place to be in here as his attack from Majors. Doing a little bit of damage, though, nonetheless, Alman. He has shaved off a large portion of the defending forces. Oh, what's happened?
Who is this?
Please don't be me. Oh, it's not me. Oh, thank goodness.
Well, we can just drop that guy. He's not important.
Who is he?
One of the computers that are here. Which one?
No.
And why? Oh,
it's like one of the observing pieces?
Oh, it's back.
Alright, that was weird. Okay. Alright, so it's back. That was on a critical juncture too, it looks like, but he did not lose his Raven to it.
He didn't ever cut that.
That would have been unfortunate. Either way, has his base on lockdown. Does Major, actually. It's getting quite low in health. Defending forces are not in great number for our Chinese Terran player. Dropping some more auto turrets. I like that. Just bypassing them completely is Major. Just dropping into the main base, taking out some more of these Marines. Oh, sick micro too.
Or pickup micro, yeah. Hey, she gets it to go. Oh, God. Nice.
Yeah. So far, so good in this little attack. Me.
Oh, wow. No way. Does he have enough damage to the cyclone?
Nah. Well, if he focuses down, maybe.
Okay.
Oh, no. There we go. Well, that worker got the kill, didn't it? No, it didn't, actually. That's bad.
I mean, he's still killing stuff, Bob. Still not over.
Yeah. It isn't. And how much health is left on this command center? Just 180 some, and lower as it's on fire right now. Needs a good old repair. It does 10 workers have gone down and continuing as this drop, you did say, has not stopped. The utility that he's got out of this drop is immense. Now, he needed to do that because his own natural base was late. He is starting to mine from it, is a Major. So, economically, he's in a pretty dang good position. And continuing with his Raven and medevac. Medevac does get cleaned up from that mine, but the Raven will get away.
Yep. Does indeed in the end there.
High level plays. Element.
Oh, another turn going down from this Raven in the main. God. Does it ever end?
Well, it's gonna get this tank. It's gonna get the tank. Oh my gosh, it's gonna get he does not get there to heal it in time. The auto turret does manage to take out that one siege tank. That hurts so much four time. And even so, on top of this, the health on this orbital command is super low, but now just being healed by a SCV. The fire burned it down to about 80 health.
Close. So
good thing he's paying attention.
I mean, I guess if he focused that CC instead of the tank, he would have killed the CC, is what you're saying. Or how low in health was the tank? Was it full health?
Oh, full health tank, yeah.
Oh yeah, so it would have died then.
He would have easily got the orbital command. But then again, it would have, because then the workers would be closer to heal it.
Yeah, you're right. They would have pulled straight to the CC, because it's on the path there. Good call, Bob. You know better than me about TBT. You are the Terran player, after all.
Oh, man, you were the Mass Raven player back in the day. Holy jeez, Element. We got a $20 donation from Lib75. It's like, can't wait, that analysis. Geesh, I love GSC Sad.
That's the violin, Bobby.
Oh, the violin guy.
Oh, boy. The sad violin.
Oh.
That mule went to the back to die. I guess he didn't want the mule to take another patch of minerals on such a low time. That's a
All right, thank you so much,
Lipsy5. Right,
we'll give you a proper shout out after this game. It's done as deserved. Thank you so much. Long term supporter, man. Lipsy5, holding down the fort, as always.
Yeah, Lipsy75. Just, I mean, every time we gotta shut him out, we need like some credits at the end of this. He's rushing back to get on that chat to mod the heck out of it. We need credits, Bob. You gotta get on that. And
I gotta get on that.
You know, you do.
Like, I have files and stuff ready for that sort of thing. Just didn't know what we were gonna use it for. So yeah.
Well, now you know. If you didn't know, now you know. But and then, you know, holding down the chat, giving these donations to support us, keep us going. Just major shout out to Lib. But it looks like we do have a drop going into the base of Major right now, and I think probably going to be dropping it inside.
There is indeed, Element. But the drop in Major's base is chased away immediately. Now can time say the same thing as the tanks will sieged up? A lot of the forces four time are getting obliterated by the siege tanks. There is one tank putting in some work, but the siege tanks will focus it down immediately. Oh. That's it. GG is called. GG is called. Major takes game number two. It was just death by a thousand punches in the face element, and that's ended up what happened there. Time could not sustain.
And we're gonna get to this game here, Bubba. Game number three here, coming on up. And I think if I can do this correctly, there we go. Okay, is this map a little dark? Possibly, but Bob doesn't mind if I don't mind either. All right, in the bottom right corner, guys, it is Major. Still love that intro. Take it away, Bobby.
Yeah. Took me a long time to do, too, because I had to line things all up. Anyway, to the northwest side of the map, we have the red Terran player. It is X-Team's time.
Good stuff. Anyways, well, nothing's happening right now. We might as well, hold on. You talk about something for a second, Bobby.
Okay. So what we see coming from both players, we got the double gas going down for time, only the single gas for Major. So slight deviation here in their openers. I expect a fairly similar opening that we've seen in the previous series from time, as he likes to stick with the double Reaper into Hellion, into Cyclone, both defensively and aggressively. Now from Major himself, it looks like he may opt for a standard CC pretty quickly, actually, by the looks of it. He already has the SCV in the low ground. There it is. Drops the CC. And so a significant deviation, actually, in their openers. Now, the idea for the opener of time is to get some damage done on this, at least. I mean, if his opponent's doing the same thing, that's really just mitigated. But with this economic opening from Major... Okay, Solomon.
Really quickly, you can get right back to it after. Pressy 2 Fool, there is your picture in picture. In picture. And Bob, continue your story.
Okay. Oh, I was just saying that what time needs to do is get some damage done at this natural base, in other words. Just do their openings. His own natural base is going to be significantly delayed. He has that Cyclone, as I mentioned before, on the way. It's about a quarter of the way done now as we speak. And we'll see what he could do, though. I mean, this is an interesting map to do this on. You have the north. You can come from the northeast here into Major's base, or through this small choke point near these rocks at the lower ramp near the natural. But in the meantime, looks like Major himself is pumping out a Cyclone 2. It's about a third of the way done, a couple Marines as well, units that he'll need to defend against the likely oncoming push from time. Again, spotted that there is no natural base, has Major with his hero SCV scouting that there's nothing on the low ground here. I don't think he has actually scanned in the main base of time, so seeing if there's a high ground CC, a little bit unknown to him so far. But I think it could be assumed at this point, considering what he's seen at the front of this ramp.
Yeah, I do agree, Bobby. Your assessment.
Actually kind of like this. He's keeping a large portion of his forces, is Major, at the top of his own ramp, just to make sure he's safe in both regards. Now the push is coming out, or rather the drop is moving out for time, seeing what kind of damage it could do. He even has a Reaper moving up ahead to send back any information of the location of the large portion of Major's army.
Now it cancels the production of the base there. Very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Going to see if we can do that one more time with Reaper.
And here we go, guys. Here's the push from time. Going to try to get some damage done economically on towards Major's side of things. Major does have quite a healthy army here, though, Element. They'll all come down to micro here, perhaps, as the Marines are actually putting in so much work, even chasing away the medevac. Medevac trying to swoop in to pick up some units, but like, nope. And will get away with his life, but at what cost? A lot of the standing army for time did fall. In the meantime, we actually have some damage getting done on towards time side of things. What did I miss?
That Reaper must have just went all the way. I said he was jumping back in, but I thought he was going to go back in to cancel the base again. Looks like it went and some damage done in the actual.
Yeah, I mean six SCVs have gone down here.
7 kills does that Reaper. Oh, is that a shark again?
Okay, so that's what's going on. I'm like, that's one deadly Reaper blood, I guess. A little bit inattentiveness, I guess, there from time as he was initiating his own attack on Major's side of things. And Major did a stellar defense. Textbook, really, as first saw coming from the beginning, but it's all about execution as well. And Major just executed absolutely perfectly. And a lesser Terran would have crumbled to that well-timed attack from time.
Good job, Bob. Got that
all right. Uh-huh.
So what do we got coming out? don't know.
Well, why is the music loud, Omit? Why now?
Yeah, that's how it works in this game.
It does. It does flow up. Sometimes it gets epic at odd moments sometimes. But anyway, we have a push moving out across the map for time, looking to continue on his aggression. His own natural base is only just now mining. So he's sacrificing a lot to do this, guys, considering the supply is in favor of our blue Terran player, Major. His own natural base is on lockdown. He's mining much more healthy from it than his red Terran opponent. He has a siege tank ready, including a Raven. There's two Ravens on the field for time, so this could definitely turn the tables here, especially with the power of these auto turrets. But auto turrets being thrown down for both players. The tank does land. Melee focuses down the tank, defending tank of Major, but Major's army here is pretty large, must be respected, but just I think the support of these Ravens with that medevac and the Marines just a little bit too much at this natural base for Major. Major going back to the high ground with his forces.
That's a siege tank. So,
putting it work.
Push that back.
I think so too.
If he gets one more shot, maybe.
I mean, but 11 workers went down. I mean, that's not nothing,
still
Element.
And still, worker lead, though, is Major.
Well, and still continuing to push this attack, though, so it's the army supply that, you know, Major has to worry about that. His own siege tank is going to get focused down. It's so close! Ooh. Well, it does get taken out by the tank of... the tank of time. Forced to lift up that tank and run away is time for now. Pulling the boys, as you did say, definitely helped stave off that attack. Could have done a lot worse, but at the very least, kind of reset this game. So, well-executed attack from our Chinese Terran player as Major himself is, I guess, trying to crawl back into this. You did say work the lead. Is that still the case? Yes, actually it is. Actually, well, that's pretty healthy, in fact. A decent 6 worker lead here in favor of Major. So despite having lost 11 SDs to that... He's gonna clean it up, man. Cleaned up. Clean it up, son! Oh, ah, no, it's not gonna clean it up. Yeah. It's something, at least.
Yeah, definitely enough.
It's amazing, though, how in this matchup, in these matches that we've seen, they're very evenly matched in many regards. I mean, the first game that went to time looked like, not a beatdown, but it was like one guy was in clearly control the whole game. Second game, well, that was Major in that regard. And now this game, it's just two very powerful players. Looked like Major had a better opening in his defense, but that second push out from time kind of reset it. And it's fairly even with a slight lead I'd give to Major.
Yeah.
Okay. So what do we have here for upgrades?
Wait a minute, go down to player's element. Unfortunate. Didn't get a whole lot done of that one.
Okay, so we have that double medevac drop moving out across the map for Major, as there's nothing to spot this.
Oh, you must not have seen the drop happen. That's, I think, what occurred there.
I guess I missed something.
Definitely.
I was looking at the upgrades to seeing what was going on here. We do have a +1 attack for Major on the way, and it's about to finish. In fact, in time for this drop, it looks like. He's just waiting for it to complete, as we have no upgrades yet for our red Terran player, at least not complete. And in fact, it looks like...
We got a double attack going here. Drop into the main, gonna pull him out of position, and then attack the third at the same time, it looks like, is what Major's going to do.
Looks like it, too.
Zoom out on that and get in position.
I like this positioning of Major here initiating this engagement. This will eventually get cleaned up by the looks of it, as the forces for time will consolidate in the main base, but locking down mining alone, and even taking out... I mean, this is not free. It's not a free defense at all. Those tanks are shredding a lot of the standing forces of time. Supply is starting to plummet for time. And, wow, he lost 11 workers in that on top of a lot of army supply. An element, all that is super important, but now after the attack is... Oh, we got this. There it is, the push happening in the natural pace here. It was only distraction element.
About Bob.
Well, I thought you were talking about what was coming from his main base. I didn't realize it was here. I should look at that minimap more. So well played. Again, 28 workers going down for our red Terran player. Time is now feeling that he has to get something done. Now he's moving across the map. But what is the supporting forces here, Element? His medevacs are empty. He has, what, 3 Marines for those medevacs to heal. 3 tanks and a handful of Vikings. In the meantime, his main base is getting dropped yet again as Major's aggression is constant and nonstop. Now it looks like he's going to try a doom drop of his own in towards perhaps the newly formed third base of Major. Or he'll just forego that and go into the main completely. Yeah, he's going to go right into the main. and try to lock down the production. There's one hope here in coming back in this game, is taking a super effective and efficient engagement in the main base of Major. Well, this is nearly double the arm, the supply
the
total.
Actually, use picture and picture and picture.
It would be effective, Elm. That's for sure. That's
GG. It did for separate things, but
it was just too much.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it was, I like Time's tenacity, man. It's like, you know what? I got one option. I'm just gonna go for it. No ifs, ands, or buts. No dilly dallying. Like, we see so many players, and we don't talk about it too much because we like to hype the games up sometimes. But Time is just. Even though he lost that game, I gotta appreciate his heart and sticking in it. We have another event tomorrow, of course, as
Solar,
good times,
Masa,
yeah,
and I'm thinking it's probably gonna be these two players here, but it might be Killizer instead of one of them. We'll see. We'll find out.
Yeah.
Shut that meme music off. Get into this game here, Bobby. And in the bottom. Oh, hold on. Need to be able to spin. There we go. In the bottom right corner, Bobby, it is Major.
All right, and to the north, northwest side of the map, we have the red Terran player. It is Time.
Good stuff, Bope. All the people enjoying right, shenanigans.
You know, it has been said.
I don't, but yeah, that's good.
But definitely not by you. I wouldn't expect it, Helmet. Wouldn't expect it at all. Oh, alright, so we have a 2-1 lead. Not match point yet, guys. It's best of 7. Of course.
Yeah.
And, game 4. Now, what does Major have up his sleeves here? No, it wasn't anything ultra, like, it wasn't anything cheesy. It wasn't anything even overly decisive. It was really him just weathering the storm that is Time, and then just using his own multi-pronged aggression against Time. So it was a matter of just don't die and then kill his opponent. Pretty standard play when you think about it, but when it's usually Major the one who sets the tempo, and we've talked about it before, he's the guy who's ultra-aggressive, doing multiple-pronged attacks, drops, sniping your bases. It's just, he's against the guy who's even crazier than him. That's a sight to behold.
Sight to behold, indeed.
Command center upgrade.
Now, both of you guys are actually pretty young. Most people don't even realize. Major's only, 23 years old? So he's a young guy. And,
yeah.
But Time's 16. I mean, Time was born in the year 2000. Like.
Yeah. Oh. Jeez.
The year 2000? What was I doing in the year 2000? Well, I would have been, what?
Nothing with your life.
I don't even know.
It's not a change. Bob goes and cries for this today. He's right about everything. That's not true. That's not true at all, Bob. But probably in that music band that you're talking about, your band bros.
No, 2010? No, I was just starting to play guitar, I think, at that time. I just learned to play guitar in 2000. I went in grade 10, grade 9, somewhere in there probably.
Yeah. So,
I was playing. I would have just stopped playing hockey at that time, and then would have got into music afterwards.
Hmm. Yes, right. The you were that goalie who did those.
I was a goalie. Yeah. Those are good times, Element. Either way, let's look at this game. Who is going
to
be the aggressor this time? It looks like Time yet again.
Mind to the face.
Oh!
No, I didn't even get to get mind to the face.
Didn't even need it.
No.
Good paying attention there. Was Time. Now, as I did say, the aggressor is going to be Time yet again, as the natural is complete for Major at the low ground. This is pretty much a mirror of the previous game, and this is a different map, though, Elmeth. It's a much wider open at the foot of the natural base, so this attack from Time could definitely be much more effective than the previous.
Yeah, I do agree. Gonna get that picture and picture and picture out of there.
Oh, I scouted.
Go back to the...
He scouted Elmeth. He scouted with the
tower seal?
Zolnaga Tower. Yeah.
I think it did.
He knows what's up. This guy got shut down super hard this time. Just the fact that he saw it that early on will enable him to chase away the drop and even gets a lockdown, a couple pot shots at that medevac. Runs away with his tail between his legs. But as we know, Time is never done, Element. Time never stops as he's going to be going for even further aggression. Getting that his own CC at the high ground this time, pretty much the same time as the previous game, but we did see a follow-up attack that actually did some damage to Major in game in the previous game. We'll see if it does it this time, or if he even follows through with this attack. I'd imagine he will. And here we go. He's pushing yet again towards the natural base. Now, where's the army in the defensive army for Major? He has one mine.
Okay.
Oh, he's a hero mine, but
so he's gonna use his own mine. Oh, I tried to do the pickup micro. That didn't go well at all.
That did not go as planned.
Lost
well, at least the mine is.
You kind of needed.
Oh, there we go. There's the main army. Actually, it was in the main base. Will eventually chase away the forces of time. But, actually, pretty good mine hit. Two workers went to sacrifice for the greater good element. But there are two cyclones here, and they're doing a lot of damage. The one cyclone of Major gets micro pretty well. Will live to fight another day, at least
this
for the time being.
Come back into just
play
damage
right
here.
Now.
Oh my god!
Work! Yeah!
Oh boy! Oh god, I went full Leroy Jenkins on that one. Oh boy. That was good. Luckily, I have those limiters on, or else yours would be gone.
Oh, the limiters save us, I mean.
Yeah, I know. Blizzard would have kicked us out by now if we didn't have the limiters. You just gotta stop, dude. You're ruining our game. Please stop. Yep. Okay, so Raven is coming in here to the main base of Major. Let's see if it can drop the turret down.
Yeah, just throw a turret down, delay a little mining, maybe even get a couple kills here. If Major's not paying attention, Major will lose. There we go. Three workers going down immediately. Four to follow that up. Will eventually just disappear as it is wont to do, Element. So nice little harass there from time, but is it enough, Element? Supplies are actually pretty even between both players. But it's just, we got a third CC, about three quarters of the way done, just over three quarters of the way done, in fact, for Major, as he's looking to take that third, extend his economic lead and positioning here. What do we have? Work account. Work account's actually even here, but with that third CC, we'll definitely aid in extending that lead here for Major. I don't know. In other words, I'm liking his position. His defense was near perfect, too, again.
Oh, so, can he snipe some upgrades up to these two medivacs? Or is he going to go straight, not medivacs, ravens? Or is he going to go straight for the tank?
Tank. Oh, it's going to be
probably
the tank.
Probably the tank.
Yeah. And then, does he have energy for another one?
I think he does.
Oh, he does,
yeah,
actually.
He definitely does.
I clicked on the
wrong
raven.
Might as well get out of there. You can actually turn back and get this other raven. Oh, he's going to get it. It's gone. Super dead.
Oh, man.
And his
that's
own raven
sick.
Lives with three health. Oh, God. Plus, what the heck happened there? Oh, Lord. Everything that could have went wrong did go wrong.
Yeah. So, just little victories from a Major yet again over time. Now, it's still so even between these both players. Anything could happen. But really, again, Major has deflected time over and over again. Done his own little counter-aggression that's a little bit more effective than time. It's these marginal wins, these marginal victories element that start to snowball out of control once the mid to late game hits. And that's the, the oncoming onslaught that time struggled with in the past couple games.
Yeah, I agree.
And
I just saw that money shot again of that mine on those units in the
instant replay or not so instant replay?
No, in the casting.
Oh,
I should be pressing that button, Bob. Just too many buttons. Too many buttons. Especially
thing,
only
you
one
to,
person.
You
in
need to have it like a big arrow pointing to it, just so it reminds you. You know. Because we got the technology. It's here.
We have too much technology.
I mean, but you are by yourself today in studio, so I guess there's that.
Yeah. Anyways, pretty fairly even-sized armies here. Is there something on the map, too? There must be, right? I mean, where's the rest of it? I guess it's the tank difference. Oh, even the tanks are similar. Why does it look so much bigger? Huh. It's interesting.
Oh, optical illusion element. Optical illusion. Trying to siege up some of the production here is time. Not actually to great success. And forced to lift up here, killing a couple of these add-on structures. We'll lose a couple of Marines for his troubles, but nothing too critical. The supply significantly ahead for Major, and that's in the workers. As mentioned before, securing that third base, he did. And it's mining healthfully now. He even has a siege tank here to defend, but a double drop. Moving across to contest the third base is time here, but a double drop of Major's own moving across the map, but they do not see each other passing by healthy enough space there. It looks like, the standing army here in defense for Major is just a little bit too much. And this drop against the third won't do anything. In the meantime, the siege is continuing to happen at the main base. Element, who cares? $50! Leroy Jenkins says Corona Boy! Oh man, Corona Boy with the 50 sheet. Wow.
Bob, I'm picking your picture. Stuff is happening. But
it
my
is
God.
Indeed.
Oh, $50.
I'm gonna get that proper again after this game. But yeah, there's a siege happening here. Time is locked down a pretty decent part of Major's base. But I think Major's
so close to dying.
Stuck a board, no!
Oh, but he saves it. Oh God. And he's actually gonna get these medivacs too if he tries, if he wants to, if he felt like it, if it was okay. Oh wait, he might even get it if he doesn't feel like it. Yeah, he's going to. Didn't even feel like it.
Oh wow, he did get both. Wow. Yep. On the other side of the map, I don't know if you had that in picture or not, but still continuing to siege up here is Time. He took out the starport that was like 1 second away from producing two liberators to clear this up.
CC's gonna fall here by another, I mean the first. It goes down. Well,
yeah, CC does fall below 100 supply now is Time, though. Though as much as effective as his lockdown of the main base of Major has been, Major's adjusted accordingly. His third base has been mining for quite some time. Third base attempt gets taken out by Major, and Time is looking in dire straits right now, Element, as he, as he still has this lockdown, but this lockdown is no longer important, and he has no medivacs to really move his army around effectively.
Here. They've got to make the hold of a lifetime.
Hold of a lifetime. All right, does have a medevac, drops in, takes out that one of Viking. At least, which was being a little bit of an issue over the siege tanks of Time. Now, Time's forces have consolidated back here at this cliff face. To what end, Element? He has one medevac for support, really low in health, only at 26. Looks like Major himself is just going to collapse in on this from behind and end of this game right here and right now. It's just an overwhelming army supply lead, and I think Time recognizes that GG is called. Major takes the game and makes this series 3-1. Right now, we're going to match point now, Element. Going to match point. Game 5 coming up. Major up 3-1 versus... I'm really, really, really excited. I don't know what to expect. I have hardly watched any of the trailer stuff. I watched one trailer and then their initiative website, which is like a viral marketing thing. I've done that, but...
Yeah.
The Andromeda Initiative, it's called. It's exciting. We'll see, though. Hopefully, BioWare, come on, hit this one out of the park, BioWare, because it could go wrong. It could be lackluster and boring. It could do that. But I don't know. Don't fail us now, because they've done it with other games, but they haven't done it with Mass Effect yet. Mass Effect's been good.
Not yet, but, yeah. Give us that stroke of genius. Yeah. Good strokes anyways, Bob. In the bottom left corner, it is Major. Take it away.
And... in the northeast side of the map, we have the purple Terran player changing it up. It is Time.
Colonel Boy unsubbed after he said you use Bing. Bing in the side, Colonel Boy. Bing in the side.
It was my default thing on my browser.
Default search engine.
I actually like Bing for certain things. I like Google on most things, though.
For certain things, yes.
Yeah, well, it depends. It's like, if looking at multimedia, then it's going to be Bing. For some weird reason, its results are better. If I'm looking up, let's say, news items, I think, or like specific people, then I think Google's better on that. It depends. It is different. They're different, so that's why I use both. That's my story.
Yeah. Yeah. It's my story, too. Anyways, but we got a fairly even game opening here. Quite similar.
Oh, dead even.
Not too much difference going on.
Nope.
Real.
Well. All right, there we go. Second gas going down now for Major behind all this too. So yeah, dead even. A slight deviations here, but nothing too critical. Just in the timing more than anything else. And we'll see how they butt heads in as we head into this later stages of the early game. If it's going to be anything like, was it game number one where they both played very passive, if I remember correctly? Or was that the Kellizer series? I don't know, it's all blending together now. But it definitely was Time, though. And where they just played very passive in the beginning of the game. I think it was the first game of the series. And we'll see how this one, because a lot is on the line here. $75 to the winner, of course. The loser gets points for the Gauntlet season, which is important, to raise their rankings throughout our season. But it's the money, man. You want that 75 bones.
Giving them bones.
Yeah, man.
All the bones.
Exactly, Element.
I mean, I guess it could have been $50, $25 for second place, but you know, it's not how you do it. That's not a gauntlet, you know? You gotta make it all the way through.
Exactly. By definition.
Yeah.
Yeah. Literally
still
the name.
The second place prize for the guy who makes it through the gauntlet. It's only death.
Yeah.
Only death.
Your prize is death, yeah.
Yeah. Your prize is an honorable death. That is not the winner. That's what you get. Enjoy.
Oh, man. What are those restaurants called where it's like you have like there's knights fighting and you're eating food and you're watching it happen?
Definitely don't think this is real.
They're like themed restaurants. They're like there are knights that are pretending to fight. And
sounds like a dream to me. It's like the life of this reaper.
That's a thing, but I just don't know what they're called.
I don't know.
I'd like to go to one.
I think you're dreaming. Oh. But you know, as they say of dreams, sometimes, that's what they say, sometimes.
I thought you were going to go with the meme route.
No. Well, I was going to go to the meme route, but then I decided it was too much, it was too true, to say.
Okay.
They're real while they last, Bob. Can you say more of life? That's what it is. But, it's too deep for the morning. Too much.
That's profound.
What's this little guy doing here? Behind his tower. Oh god.
I don't know, Element.
Can this mine come get him? No.
Anyway, as I mentioned before, Element, the both players are gonna play passive as it pretty much the signs were it was already written pretty much before it happened. You can tell by how they opened up in this game. Playing it very safe in their bases, assuming the other player is gonna be the aggressor when they are doing similar builds. And both playing safe, assuming the other one's going to be doing the general double Reaper into Hellion, into Cyclones push, and that we've seen from time multiple times in this series and the previous one as well. Now, as a result of that, it's going to be depending on who decides to take that chance and go Makara out of this a little bit sooner than the other. Speaking of which, we have Major getting that third CC. In fact, it's complete turning to Orbital Command as we speak, and to apply a little bit of pressure on towards. Time side of things. He did send a Raven, but he's not doing anything with it. Kind of interesting. Maybe just thought better of it. As he will go back home, he could drop down a missile turret or an auto turret, but decided better of it. And we have a third CC on the way for time element.
We do.
No.
Bazooka Benji says, which one is Major? Well, Major is the one that is not the barcode. Major is blue.
Yeah. Major's
so
not
far,
the barcode.
Dominating
yeah.
In this series, stops the drops. The Killizer was dying to, basically. And I think that was, you know, the big part of it. Just defending those types of, those big plays that were happening. Really
yes.
Turned the game on its side.
Well, his ability to defend and deflect was what won him those games, essentially. And then the counterattacks that he initiated were too much for time to handle because he committed so much to his attacks at those time. So yeah, you could see how time is a very powerful player to an opponent who is not prepared for such commitment to these attacks. And then we saw it. We saw how Kelzer crumbled to it. And Kelzer's no slouch. Kelzer's a sick player. But he could not have.
Couple turrets going down here. Oh, just one actually, then backs right out.
Yep, he does not want to waste much energy.
Cyclone in the middle to a drop at the same time. Really wouldn't want to lose these. Okay, that's him on the tower. Blue and purple actually similar enough that from far away kind of look alike.
Yeah, but we'll get those name things sorted out, I think, for tomorrow or something. We'll figure something out after today's event, because it can be a little bit annoying when their names are barcodes or something.
We'll figure
yeah,
something
out. Yeah, because we're on the Asian server right now.
Yeah, so it's...
So that,
yeah, exactly. Exactly. Well,
a little unconventional. Logo.
You already know.
The more you know, Elvis. So we have an expeditionary force for time moving, shirking its way across the map. It's going to be met with a large portion of his forces streaming across the map. You can see on the minimap. Time is up to no good, Element, and his supply is reflecting at 133 supply to the 117 of Major. Major has actually been supply blocked a couple times in a row here. Pretty dang hardcore. And this is going to be a little bit dicey, too, once his attack does come in. Now he does get up to sensor tower just in the nick of time. And looks like it causes a little bit of pause, actually, which is a rare sight on Time's side here. Time decides to go through the middle row, taking out these rocks instead. And still, though, this is a pretty scary push coming from time. A scan goes down, sees exactly what's here to defend, and not a whole lot. As, remember, the safe play from Major is to split up his defense. And not all of his army is here, at least not in the right time.
Nice, he does skim in. For the Marines, going to push the tank, or stretch the tank fire out. Oh, those two turrets, though, perhaps.
Those turrets, though.
The saving play.
I think so, too, Almond.
It might be... He's going to get this position, at least. Can you tap into that tank already, Steve? I guess the thing is he's going to lose a couple workers here and clean it up, but... the cost there. 14 workers did go down.
Well, not heroes exactly of the day were those freehold. Ravens. With those auto turrets?
Those turrets.
That's a different story. That is a different story. Element, we had a donation too. Sergeant Duck donated $5.
Sergeant Duck? That's the second one, right?
$5. Yeah, it is. And it actually, he said to you, he says, Element heard a bright ding from his phone. He opened it and saw his Reddit app flash. New message across the screen. He already knew who it was from and dreaded opening. Turning his blinker on, he steered down the street. This is a story leading to his, then ... It ends there. Wow, like, that's actually intriguing. I'll have to read it in story voice, though. I didn't know where it was going, so I was just being in cautious voice.
I think I know who this one is. Oh, good. That's Sergeant
hilarious.
Duck? Wait, what? What's the name? Sergeant Duck? Is that what you said?
Yeah, Sergeant Duck. You donated 21 ducks before, yeah.
Okay. Oh, gosh. Is Sergeant Duck the same guy who has a couple stories featuring me and Jack Attack? I'll have to figure it out.
Oh, that's a good point.
I need confirmation on this. Because that's where it seemed like it was going.
Well, thanks to the 5 sheets, Sergeant Duck, and the interesting story, I'm actually genuinely intrigued with this case.
Where does he go? Where does he die? Where does the ellipsis lead, Bo?
Anyway, where's the street lead?
Both sides here, and looks like he's gonna pull back his time, but
well, I don't know. This is pretty devastating damage in the main base, so
I
have to figure out something.
He's gonna lose the CC. Yeah, that's going down, right? How far can you go? Actually, can you go on this ledge?
Oh, it's safe, actually. Man.
Yeah, I thought you could walk all the way in that ledge. Can't. The upgrade does go down though. Already painful as it is.
This push will eventually get cleaned up here, I guess, or at least chased away. The time will live to fight another day. He himself has secured a base, actually, at the fourth base location, so his mining will be actually a little bit slightly ahead of Major for the time being. Now, the question is, can he hold off against this army, the standing army that Major does have, Element? What is actually the army supplies? I should put up your overlay. It's actually
frustrating. Well, I think that's a story that already happened.
Donate
it's available for the public to view on the Reddit somewhere. I'm thinking. Quite certain. Anyways, we have... Looks like a big... Oh my god! It's gonna get caught! Oh!
Oh, well, what? One went down or is that two? I missed it. There we go!
Oh my god! One, but four of the five went down! GG is called! Wow!
Wow! Speaking of, we're talking about how time does these all these big doom drops, right? This is his bread and butter.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. You know what Major just did? He just threw that bread and butter in his face. Man, he just... It's like... I've never seen something actually so hard shut down in my life. The closest thing is like a drop is coming to your base and the Protoss player has a bunch of... Templars and he feedbacks your army. That's the only thing that could come close to that.
Yeah, I mean, one time he tried to dab you on Facebook was a pretty hard shutdown too, but other than that, wow. My god.
Yeah. I mean, that's expected. This was not. Well, I mean, there's a little bit of luck in that too, but just Major was moving out that way, and it just a little bit of bad luck on Time's part that his Doom Drop got spotted, because I mean, yeah, because the move-out was happening, a large portion of Major's forces would have been caught way out of position, and that drop could have done great damage, and as we saw Time do against Kelizer, but that just, fate was not in Time's favor this time, and worked against it. But I want to give a big shout out to the people who participated in today's event. Obviously, congratulations to Major for winning this event, taking home that $75,